Recently, this transgender girl who lives, you know, in the same area as me, Kings Mill, which is within the same area, Cincinnati, you know, the tri-state area, you know, committed suicide by jumping, you know, in front of a trailer, tractor trailer. She traveled like 2-4 miles from her house to the interstate to jump in front of a car to kill herself, because the way, first of all, her parents treated her, you know, super Christian, no, we can't allow this in society, and I think that's fucked up, how we treat trans people, you know. I think that's deplorable, how we treat them. You know, let alone gay and lesbians, but transgender people, like, I don't know, like, we just treat them like shit, and it's disgusting. They're another human being, and you're daring to treat them like that? You know, I'm so grateful, honestly, because I am a white Christian male. I have it so good. You know, I could be a black man in the street being shot. Or a Muslim who's Arabian being harassed. Or being a woman and being paid less for probably doing more work than my male counterpart. That's bullshit. That in 2014, almost 2015, we allow these things to happen. And I think it's my duty as someone with power, you know, with a voice, a white Christian male. Let's face it, if I were black, my life probably would be tougher. Or a woman. Or an atheist. No, my life would be a hell of a lot tougher. And I think it's indicative that, you know, you need someone with power. Help people without power. You know, if you are in a position to help other people, I think it's your duty, especially, you know, as an American, to help your fellow American and make sure they get to live their lives. You know, I don't understand with this why we want to take away other people's happiness so much. Yeah, it may infringe on your religion, but that's the thing. It's your religion, not theirs, you know. Freedom of religion. They have the right to believe what they want. And you can't just make their life hell because it goes against your religion or beliefs. You can't do that. Okay, it's another human being with their own damn mind to think for themselves. You can't just force them to believe that, especially physically, like harm them and stuff. That's just fucking crazy, you know. And that's just my little rant. You know, rest in peace Leelah. She was born Josh, but you know, chose to live. And that's another thing, like in the new local news, because you know, it's because this was breaking news in my local area, the way they covered it, you know, it was like local boy killed, or they're gonna have a moment of silence for him. And you know, I do understand, you know, the parents probably gave them that information and told him he and stuff. You know, the news isn't going to necessarily know that she was transgender. You know, they're not going to really know that. I get that. You know, in the beginning, you know, they can only go rely on what they're told. And to be honest, it was just like something passing by, like in the news. You know, like, oh, like, you know. And then local news, a teenage boy was struck on the interstate. We have no reason why he was. Yada yada. But you know, there has been a lot of backlash saying, you know, why haven't you, now that you know he's transgender, she's transgender, excuse me, why haven't you know you've said something, corrected it? I understand. In all honesty, it was just a small nuisance. I understand that. You know, I don't expect something like that to be a big news. But you know, once you found out, you know, at least correct it. It's all you can do for her. Like, really? Like, I understand, you know, you don't want to seem political and stuff like that. You know, I don't think they're doing it without malicious intent. And more than likely, you know, like 99% of news stories, local news stories, they only mention it once, 30 seconds, never mention again, or forget about it. Same stuff every day. But still, at least give her the dignity to correct it. That's all you could do. Well, that's my little rant. And like I said, if you're in a position of power, that's what it is, you know. Or, you know, not necessarily like, I have power to make you do so. But, you know, like, black people have a power over black people. Men have a power over women. And not that they're better or stronger, it's just society has given them this leverage. And if you have that leverage, I like that, instead of power, leverage. If you have that leverage, and you know it, use it to balance out things. Use it to help other people, you know. Especially, you know, if you were blessed with a great life, you know, you're a white, Christian, rich male, wife, kids, and stuff. No, I'm not saying it's your duty to help other people. But, you know, but don't sit there bitching about, oh, they're complaining, or they don't work hard enough, or, you know, you're stuck in your bubble, get out, help other people. You know, I understand it's tough getting out of your comfort zone, but when you do it, you will feel so much better, and you're going to make the world a better place. And, you know, I don't think that's much to ask for, to make sure our kids have a better life than us, live in a better world than us. I know it's a lot, but I don't think it's that much to ask for. Well, I hope I guys made you think, and probably not many people are going to watch this or care about it. Many of you are probably going to be like, ew, transgender people are like fucking faggots who are burning to hell. But you know what, that's alright. Because, you know, at least I spoke my mind, tell them how it is, and, yeah, it may not be a lot, but, and I'm not going to be like, yeah, I made a video to talk about stuff, I'm going to feel better about my stuff. So, no, because after this, I am going to, like, I do try to help other people. So I'm not one of those people who are like, I'm gonna say, you know, we should do this, but in real life, I'm not, because, you know, that's work. No, I'm going to go out and do it, and I think you guys need to go out and make sure people who don't have as big as a leverage as you get that leverage. Well, I hope you guys have a tremendous day. On winter break, so I'm probably gonna go and take a nap. Bye.